the Olympic Stadium and then collapsed on the floor. What a shame that was. And there they come out. And there's Linford Christie walking out to collect his gold medal.
The march out for the presentation of the 100-metre medals. Gold to Great Britain, silver to Namibia, and the bronze to the United States of America. Linford Christie is entitled to enjoy to the full this moment. 32 years old, captain of the British team, a member of Thames Valley Harriers, watched by his coach Ron Rodden. We're told actually in international events that he rarely runs well when Ron is actually in the stadium, but Ron warmed him up tonight and then took his seat in the stadium. We've not seen him yet. A partnership which has, produced rich rewards. Commonwealth gold, twice European gold, and now the greatest prize of all, Olympic gold. Linford Christie's winning time, 9.96. Primo Nebbiolo, President of the International Amateur Athletic Federation, congratulates the fastest man in the world in 1992. The Olympic champion. Other men may have run faster this year, but not on the night it mattered most, when they were head-on in competition. The slighter figure of Frankie Fredericks, one of the newer Olympic nations, Namibia. A silver medal. His time, 10.02. And leading the applause, ringing round the arena, the champion himself. Linford Christie, one of the most popular of athletes, with fellow competitors and spectators everywhere. And in third place, a friend of his, Dennis Mitchell, the American champion, taking the bronze medal. Well, we had a number in the opening ceremony, Friends for Life. There were three Friends for Life there. As they turn in a moment to face the flagstaffs, the raising of the Union Jack and the playing of the national anthem. Linford enjoying the athlete's moment of glory, the greatest prize of all, the Olympic title.
Well, that's a fabulous moment, and Linford Christie will be coming to talk to us all.